name is Ruth, reporting from Platform Media International. I'm live in Lagos, Nigeria. I'm on the streets of Lagos. And today's topic is Twitter ban. So let's go and search for people and hear what they have to say about Twitter ban, if it's a good decision that the government has made, if they're affected by it positively or negatively. Let's go. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. Me, Michael, and he has his own opinion about Twitter ban. So let's hear from you.
Yeah, actually, when I heard it, I got astonished because it's not good. When I heard it, it's not really good. And
okay.
That the president banned the Twitter.
Mm.
Because I think initially you have like put a warning, not just to ban.
Just like that.
Just like that. Because when he posted something on Twitter, many people are commenting, and then before you know it, now informed that they should delete it.
Mm.
And he just got upset with it. And I think when he did, took the decision, it wasn't a good one. And maybe he was upset. And that's why they say that whenever you're angry, you don't need to take decision whenever you are upset. So I don't know. It's not really wise.
Okay.
I think he should put like a warning.
Okay.
Then if the populace didn't adhere to it, like when, that's the way now like to put an end to it, but not just to ban it and I don't think it's wise.
Okay, so has it affected you in any way? Maybe you sell your market on Twitter?
Actually, no.
Or you actually, get updates, news, and all of that from
yes,
Twitter?
Yeah, exactly. That update, I think.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Because I saw many people that really attacked him. So people like, someone like Faz, who's a Nigerian musician.
Yes.
He had said a lot of things that if actually he can really, it's because he said that he would teach people that are destroying government property in the Southeast the lesson they will understand. And Faz was like, he couldn't even teach bandit, all these Boko Haram, Hess men. The blessing they will understand is it people that are destroying. So I think it's not really a good one. It's not a good one.
Okay. So,
but it's not really affected me in any. It's just that update and that information,
okay.
Which is very very indispensable in one's life.
Yeah.
You have to be updated and know what is happening. But through that, by I think that of Twitter, I think that one I'm no longer hearing any information from because they have been banned.
Okay.
Yes.
That's all. Thank you very
God
much.
Bless you.
Thank you for
okay.
coming.
Thank
Bye.
You.
Okay, so you have it. It said that the government would have at least warned us before you go straight into banning. So let's talk to someone else. Let's hear other people's opinion. Okay, so we have with me Peace. Let's hear what Peace has to say about Twitter ban.
Hello, madam.
Hello. Good afternoon. So, about the Twitter ban, for me, I think it's a very wrong decision and a very wrong step.
Okay.
So we all know that the social media is a very large, community where people do a whole lot of things, like business, have fun. You know, some people like get to have their social media presence, and people are being known through these social media platforms. And basically, the Nigerian government have no jobs to offer to the youths of Nigeria. So most of these people who are talented, like they make their living out of this whole social media thing, especially Twitter and Instagram. So why would you ban what is giving these people money when you know you are not ready to give them a good job? Like recently, I saw something on someone's page. And then the person in that pictorial diagram, the person pictured a very large crowd, meaning graduates, and then a very drop, just one drop of what that is job. And now young youths are making a living out of Twitter, Instagram, like social media, and then you are banning it for what? So for me, it's a very, very, very wrong step. That's not what we should be talking about now. There are so many things that we should be talking about in Nigeria, like security. I mean, the security in Nigeria is zero. It's bad. So we should be talking about security. I remember those days when I was really young. I grew up in the north.
Okay.
Like, so each time you're coming back to the east, to my village, we derive pleasure coming back through night bus to arrive in the morning. But now you will not go try them. You won't try it coming from the north to the east through night bus. You go fear. Even when I was going for NYS in Zamfara, You know, at some point we had to sleep on the road. We were all scared because it was night. So, what are we talking about? If I can be scared because I'm going to another state in the same country, so what are we talking about? We should focus on security. We should focus on job. Now, many youth in Nigeria, you see a graduate of health science, you see a graduate of accounts or some other thing, doing something different. Graduates are now vendors of clothes, vendors of shoes, vendors of hair on Instagram. Is that supposed to be the major goal of graduating from university? That isn't supposed to be the major goal of graduating from university. That should be like a side hustle, a second option. If I'm graduating with 2-1, I should get a better job.
Exactly.
If I'm graduating with first class, I should get a better job in my field that I studied. I did health science, and since I graduated and served, I've not been able to get any job in the health science field. I'm into entertainment because it's my passion. This is where Twitter and Instagram now comes in.
Yeah.
So why would you ban Twitter? Why would you ban Instagram? So my humble opinion is this, please. The Twitter ban is really, really wrong. That is not their business. That is not what they should be looking at. That is not what they should be thinking of. They should look for something else, security, and provide jobs for the youths in the country. Make Nigeria a better place. These countries that Nigerian youths are traveling out to go and stay, Nigeria is actually better than most of these countries. We have resources more than these countries. But because our leaders are gullible, they are gullible, packing everything inside their pockets. They cannot make Nigeria better. So they should try and make Nigeria better. So all of us will stay in Nigeria and make Nigeria better. They should start from there. So please, Twitter ban is a no-no for me. That is even not what they should be thinking about. Their time don't pass. Not to concern them, concern social media. So they should not ban it. They should leave it because this is a source of income for so many youths. For a whole lot of people. I'm coming back from a shoot right now, a skit shoot. So what gives me the platform? Social media, Instagram, Twitter. So why would they ban it? So it's a no-no for me. That's not the main focus. They should look for security. They should make Nigerian security better. They should provide jobs for youths. Yeah, so that's my take.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Peace.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, so you've heard Piso. Nigeria government should work on security, job opportunities, and a whole lot more, and not ban Twitter and allow the youth to suffer the more. So let's look out for other people and hear what they have to say.
Do you need that parcel to deliver urgently? Are there errands you need to run over time with Pemichi? Do you need those letters, report, cards, etc. delivered today, but it seems impossible? Mind your business and we will mind the rest of your business, because helping you is our business. With same day delivery, we deal on pick up and drop off, bulk mail delivery, errand services and emergency delivery. Same day delivery, we deliver our packages in the most timely and efficient manner. Contact us today and we will be there. You need not move an inch. Same day delivery, we deliver in 24 hours.
Same day, speed delivery.
So I have with me Samuel, and let's hear what Samuel has to say about Twitter ban. Hi,
well,
Samuel.
Yeah, hi, Samuel. How are you doing?
I'm good.
So basically, if I'm about to go straight to the point, I would just say it's power being projected wrongly. We have been hearing a lot of news about things going on during the protest and all that, yeah? To me, everything connects. Once again, the people in power, which are the wrong people that should be there, are using their power wrongly. Because there are a lot of problems going on in the country, yeah? You feel that they should focus on the bigger fish. But instead, they tend to look at something that is very, very weak. Because if you can drive the youth home when they came in person, then what's the big deal with the youth doing a little bit of noise making on the internet? It doesn't actually tally, if you ask me. They should focus on the big fish.
What the fuck, like?
You insulted me on Twitter. Ah, I'm angry. Bruh, they are killing people in the north, in the south, in the west, in the east. There's one on Namdi here and all that. And you are pissed off because they brought down your post on Twitter. For real, man. That's what you use your power for,
bruh.
Too much. Yeah, and to be honest, I feel they shouldn't talk too much about this. That if something should be dropped, it should be something brief that they actually have the ability to understand. Because I feel us youths, and when we're doing our protest, we're talking too much, and we start using that talking too much to invite things that weren't relevant. Okay. So they don't take us seriously. If Twitter itself was supposed to be a tool, it won't even be strong enough to do anything. That's just the honest truth. There's nothing Twitter can do to harm the government we have. Let me just be honest. Even if they involve Instagram, they involve Facebook, they say, that is not what will affect them, because they are just them in power. Man, it's crazy what's going on in the East now. It's crazy, right? Yeah, in the South too, huh? I feel that is way stronger to get their attention than even the Twitter that they are focusing on. Are you seeing? People are fighting back. We are fighting back in one way or the other. You get? So technically, why are they not focusing on people that always don't have any weapon on them? You see how they always focus on people that don't have weapons. But you see that guy, anybody that can help us and go and get him. Catch that. Help us and go and get him. They are afraid. You know, we'll give them a so. How much was it? Do you have an idea of how much? It's a very big sum. I think last time was like 100 mil for that nigga head. And the nigga be on Facebook, he be like, okay, y'all know where I live. I ain't hiding my address. If you got the balls, come through. He bougie with this thing. He's Donald Trump with this thing, man. The nigga walking sack long on the ground. His sack is touching the ground and all that. The guy is. He's not afraid of anything, and we need more people like him. We are not in a world that we can be gentle. The Bible says that right from the time of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God have been suffering violent, and the violent take it by force. So technically, if you want this thing, we have to take it by force. You know, practice what you preach. Don't be on your phone in your house when you're supposed to be, you know, defending what is right outside. You know, we like to be beautiful, handsome, like you obviously are. But sometimes we should get our hands dirty. You know, we need to. I'm done.
Thank you.
I'm good. If I run out of things to say.
Thank you, Sam. Thank you, Samuel. Samuel's done a whole lot. Let's see if we can get one or two people to say something. We'll be right back. Okay, so I have with me Chidi. Let's see what Chidi has to say about Twitter ban.
Hello, how are you doing?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Okay, Twitter ban. The way I see it is like the government taking us 10 years backwards. Okay. Instead of embracing new technologies and trying to do better like other first world countries, mm-hmm. We are going back because of personal opinion, because of what people feel. I just feel that this is it's too personal. The opinion of the Nigerian people is not really considered before they took these decisions.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you.
What I actually feel is that Twitter is a general platform where people communicate.
Okay.
And I think the government are feeling intimidated because of the way the youth are communicating. This is where we can pass our information across to other nations or all over the world. Mm-hmm. And some people have been affected with their business. This is where people sell their things. And a lot of people have been down with this because I actually don't know what to say again.
Okay, please come.
I don't know what to say again. You got me on that way.
No, I don't say anything. Just round up. Just say that you're.
Okay, I'm actually not going to
eat. That's just say.
Okay, can I?
Yeah.
So, to me, my opinion is I think they should bring back Twitter because it's really not a good idea. You banning Twitter. I mean, let's just have our own opinion. Let's. Just bring our Twitter. We want Twitter back. Just bring it back, please. Let go now.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. So Veronica is saying, please bring back our Twitter. Nigerian government. Bring back our Twitter. Oh. Okay, so I have with me beautiful Olichi. Let's see what Olichi has to say.
What do you have to say about Twitter ban?
I mean, clearly it's not right, and it's just one of those things that shows you that if you can get out of the country, it's best to get out quickly. Because, I mean, they banned Twitter, they can as well ban us from leaving, so if you can leave, just try to leave. I mean, it's clearly not right, but we've been saying it since, like, from what they did during NSAS, killing, it's not like the country, the government would do any and everything to shut us up, really. So I don't see any way out of it other than leaving, if you can leave. If you can't leave, just keep praying. Okay. Really.
Thank you. Thank you for your time, Olichi. So she said it, that if you have the opportunity to japa, if you have the opportunity to leave the country, then you can leave. All right. Okay, so I have with me Emmanuel. Let's see what Emmanuel has to say. Hi, Emmanuel.
Hi.
So what do you have to say about Twitter ban in Nigeria?
Twitter ban, it's not really good to ban Twitter. It's not really good. In this age, it's very, very important for the youth and business people. The Twitter ban is affecting we in some ways or many ways, because many people don't go out. They do their shopping or
online.
buy something online. So from there, they will call us, they will send us message, they will order, then we go and pick and deliver. So banning Twitter for me is not good, it's bad. So they should unban it.
Okay.
Yes, that's my stance. So it's not good for this generation.
Okay.
Yes, that's
thank
my
you.
Stance.
All right. Thank you very much. Thank you. So Emmanuel said that Twitter is affecting their business. They're into courier service, and of course, the world has gone digital, and we do our shopping online sometimes, and we would need courier services to help us deliver our stuffs. Okay.
What do we talk just as if you seen at the Twitter, but I mean our Twitter.
Anyone?
Okay. Yeah, just we say nobody should be our problem now. I beg you. But which can president, which can leaders God give us? See better things, bandits. But then I ESC, I would say they call them kili kili everywhere. Very soon our militants, Nigerian Delta militants, they go join. What suppose they talk about which it makes sense? My Twitter. Even when the meaning of Twitter, you know. I'm not sure that you know. Twitter. Shame of them. Shame at them. Shame on them.
Anyone?
Oh God, no man. Alex.
Okay, thank you, Alex. Okay. A lot has been said. What do you think about Twitter ban? You can comment, like, share, and follow us on all social media platforms at Platform Media International. And please do not forget to subscribe on our YouTube channel, Platform Media International. Bye.
Welcome to Same Day Delivery, home of errands and parcel deliveries within Lagos. Thank you for choosing Same Day Delivery. We offer emergency delivery service, pay on pickup or on delivery, convenient payment system, insured packages, value for money, and lots more. Call Same Day today on 090-6000-8220 or visit www.thesameday.com. Same Day. Speed Delivery.